Hey, Nerd Herd, I'm Rich Dotson, a founder of DynastyNerds.com, and I'm here today to kick off the 2021 Dynasty season with three of my favorite Dynasty buys. When it comes to buying young, talented Dynasty players, you cannot be afraid to be aggressive. You never want to be stagnant in your Dynasty League, as that'll only get you passed up by your league mates. So let's dive in here on a couple players and a couple guys that I think will help you in 2021. Remember, what seems like an overpay today can be a vast underpay tomorrow. And in Dynasty, you always want to get ahead of the curve. And buying low is a great opportunity to do that. So we're going to do that this offseason. We're going to find some buys. We're going to talk about some sells. We're going to discuss rookies. But today, we're going to talk about some of my three favorite buys here as we just kick off the 2021 season. So let's get into it. Three of my guys that I think will help change your Dynasty franchise for the 2021 season. Who wouldn't want a young, versatile wide receiver on their Dynasty team with 4 years of experience under the age of 25? That's as desirable as winning three straight Dynasty championships filled with a league of your ex's lovers. Well, go ahead this offseason and trade for Curtis Samuel and turn those desires into reality with this electric playmaker that doesn't turn 25 until August 11th. He's been in the league for 4 years. Samuels is coming off a career year through week 16 with 70 receptions for 733 yards and 293 yards rushing on 38 carries, accumulating 5 total touchdowns while playing 68% of the snaps. His 38 carries were enough to eclipse his first 3 years combined of 31. These numbers were good enough to finish as wide receiver 26 with 193 points in PPR leagues, a high-end wide receiver 3. If you get out your Dynasty investigative shovel and dig just a little deeper, you'll see there was a big difference between the first half of the season Curtis Samuel and second half of the season Curtis Samuel. In the first half of the season, the Panthers relied heavily on head coach Matt Rhule's former college player at Temple and free agent signee of 2 years for $20 million, along with their, and that's Robbie Anderson, along with their dynamic 23-year-old 2018 first-round pick, DJ Moore. From weeks 1 through 8, Robbie Anderson was wide receiver 11, and Moore was wide receiver 16. While Samuel was the lowest of wide receiver threes at 36 in PPR leagues. Jump ahead to the second half of the season, weeks 9 through 16, and Samuel finished strong as wide receiver 18 and was wide receiver 16 overall in points per game. Anderson slipped to wide receiver 31, Moore to wide receiver 39. Samuel enters the 21 free agency market, and it's hard for me to envision him resigning with the Panthers. They have a projected $17 to $25 million to spend, with a need to sign their young, talented right tackler, Taylor Moten. He'll be among some of the strong names for NFL teams to choose from the likes of Allen Robinson, Chris Godwin, Juju Smith-Schuster, Kenny Galladay, Corey Davis, and Will Fuller. I can see all of these receivers being more desirable than NFL GMs and Dynasty GMs as well. All are solid additions, but of the price tag, Samuel could be the best bang for your buck. And like the 4th of July, or a date that's gone well, who doesn't love a good bang? Samuel is also younger than all of them except for Juju. That's just by a couple months. Samuel, the former 2017 high second-round pick, has tried to find his role in this Panthers offense, but it was new offensive coordinator Joe Brady that helped show off Samuel's dynamic athletic ability. Samuel was previously used on deeper routes his first 3 years, which was not Cam Newton's strength. And last year, dealing with Kyle Allen's Tyrannosaurus Rex arm that threw 20% of his uncatchable balls did not help Curtis Samuel either. Brady stepped in and created multiple different ways to get the ball in Samuel's hands with a ton of jet sweeps and line him up in the slot. And he really shined there in the slot. Brady helped Samuel finish with a career year and one of the top third down receivers in the NFL, finishing with the highest catch percentage on third downs amongst receivers with 10 or more catches. 17 of his 25 receptions went for first downs. All of this on tape will make Samuel a coveted asset for any NFL team. Trading for Samuel shouldn't cost you a farm or a keg. I'd be more than happy to give up a high 21 second and third together as a package to get a guy like Samuel. A player close to equal value of a position of strength on your team as well would be a good bet way to go. Samuel should get a nice 4-year contract in free agency and land with a team that's likely has a better quarterback situation than he's ever had with the Carolina Panthers. I'd personally love to see Samuel land with the Green Bay Packers, who'd immediately increase Samuel's value to line up across wide receiver 1 overall, Devontae Adams. The Packers are also likely to lose Aaron Jones in free agency, putting Samuel in line to offset A.J. Dillon with some rushing opportunities, which he had a career year doing here in Carolina, former Ohio State running back. He had the potential to finish the year as a high-end wide receiver two in Green Bay. However, no matter where Curtis Samuel ends up in free agency, I believe it'll be the beginning of a great stretch of dynasty success. Don't let another league mate enjoy all these fantasy points and go out there and trade for Samuel today. And I'll await your thank you telegrams in 2022. Another wideout that I'd love to make a move for this offseason is DJ Chark of the Jacksonville Jaguars. After a breakout 2019 campaign where he led the Jaguars in targets with 118, receiving yards with 1,008, and receiving touchdowns in 8, finishes wide receiver 16 overall despite missing 2 games with injury, Chark had a rough 2020 like most of us. Then again, outside of James Robinson, the entire Jaguars team had a rough 2020. The Jags blew up their team worse than a late night of drinking followed by a $50 Taco Bell order. This team won the tank, and they tanked so big it could fit a blue whale into that disaster, as they locked up the number one overall pick in the 2021 NFL Draft. Now, locking up that number one pick and securing generational quarterback talent at Trevor Lawrence of Clemson makes this buy even more enticing. Lawrence is a can't-miss prospect that likes to turn a franchise around and make everyone around them better. This helps the likes of Laviska Shenault, James Robinson, and of course, our guy here, DJ Chark. Their 6'4", blazing wide receiver one. Players coming off a down year always open the door for a great deal to be had, and that's what we have here with the 24-year-old DJ Chark, whose best days are ahead of him in Jacksonville. Chark has late first-round value, but you can let him get him. You can likely get him for less today. You know, a player you don't want to trade for, a couple draft picks, or maybe a future draft pick. The Jaguars' defense is surely not an overnight fix either, and the Trevor Lawrence-led Jaguars will be likely playing a lot of catch-up in 2021, putting Chark in position for the late-game garbage points, only this time, he is a QB that can throw him the football. Finally, who doesn't love to get their hands on a great tight end? The tight end position is a great spot to get the edge over your opponents because the bottom tier, aren't too off from being even tight end twos. They're pretty close. If you can end up with a top-tier tight end, it'll give you the edge your team needs come playoff time versus other talented dynasty teams. This is why this offseason, I'm making trades for Dolphins tight end 25-year-old Mike Gesicki. The former star at Penn State crushed the 2018 NFL Combine with a top-tier spark score and ended up the second tight end drafted at pick 42. Tight ends usually take 2 to 3 years to truly develop, and Gesicki has taken great steps forward in each year of his career, coming off back-to-back years as a tight end one, with finishes of tight end 12 in 2019, tight end 7 in 2020. Gesicki's stock is rising, along with the rest of the Miami Dolphins football team. The Dolphins are loaded with draft picks, which include the 3rd overall pick in the 1st and 2nd round, courtesy of that Laremy Tunsil trade to go with a young, talented defense. They'll likely add another receiver from this deep 21 rookie class because it's so loaded with receivers to go along with Gesicki, Devontae Parker, and Preston Williams to help the promising to soon-to-be second-year quarterback in Tua Tagovailoa. If they could add a talented running back, either through free agency or draft, it'd help this team even more so open up things past that line of scrimmage. This offense should take a big step forward in 2021 with increased fantasy production across the board. And you'll want some shares of that. And Gesicki is a great share to get. Probably one of my favorites on the Dolphins. Gesicki's athleticism flashed all year long, with him making big play after big play for the Dolphins while showing great hands with numerous ESPN highlights and one-handed catches. That one versus the Bengals was one of the best catches I saw all year. Gesicki could easily find himself as the Dolphins' best target this upcoming season, put him in Travis Kelce or George Kittle role, and securing his place in the Tier 1 of Dynasty tight ends. Those Tier 1 players are hard to come by and even harder to trade for due to supply and demand. So get ahead of the curve and trade for him today. Thanks for watching. Make sure you like, subscribe, and hit the notification buttons below so that way you don't miss a show this offseason as we're here at Dynasty Nerds are dedicated to do what we do best, help you build a title contender. So let's spend this offseason together finding some great buys, some buy lows, some players to get out from under while their value is still high, and find that next rookie to help your Dynasty team for the next decade. Make sure to check out DynastyNerds.com, of course, for all our daily content, and try the Dynasty GM for free, the best Dynasty tool on the market today to help you streamline and manage all your Dynasty leagues, and of course, help with trades with that trade calculator. Best tool on the market, get to DynastyNerds.com. It's free to try today.